Welcome back to Nightline. I hope you've been enjoying our program tonight as we've been talking about the Psalms. Just in a little bit, Don Harkins will be back with us. So many of you have been calling in. You know, Vera, I don't know your last name, ma'am, but I understand that you're 88 years old, and you said you love all the Psalms, but Psalm 100 is your favorite. Thank you so very, very much. And for so many of you who've called in tonight, our prayer partners have been praying with you. We'll be praying collectively for all of you who've called in toward the end of our program. But we want to remind you, please, that we are always in need of our prayer partners. I like to push on that because if you'll call us here at the station between business hours, ask for Amanda. And if not, leave us your name and number. We'll get back in touch with you. If you'd like to be a prayer partner, boy, we'd love to have you. We'd love to share with you how you can do that. And it would be a blessing. It might be your small group Bible study group. And you could do it one night a week, just once a month. You could do that. And how God would bless you. You would just enjoy talking and praying with folks. I'm just telling you. And just listening. Sometimes folks just need a listening ear. You know, God's been good to us. I know these are tumultuous times. We recognize that. We see that there is a virus. And I don't know if it is a physical or a spiritual virus. And it could be both. I mean, I know that people are getting sick and they go to the hospitals and they stay home and they take the medicines. But there could be a spiritual virus, and we're trying to take things into our own hands and into the streets instead of laying them at the feet of Jesus. But that's for another time. Right now, Court Heath, how great thou art. Woo! Come on, Kurt.
Take away my sin. paths of acclamation and take me home. What a joy that fills my heart. Then I shall bow. In humble adoration, and then proclaim, my God, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, I say good night to thee.
Now, if that didn't touch your heart, old Kenny Moore would tell you your wood's wet, all right? I just want you to know, glory. Listen, if he'd have sung another verse, there'd have been a hole up there in the roof. I'd have been gone. I'm just here to tell you. Someone wanted to know, excuse me, Don, somebody wanted to know what I was wearing tonight, my socks. And so I'll let you see, them, and then we'll keep talking. You got a picture of that, Monica? That's what I'm wearing tonight. Those are my Wizard of Oz socks, okay? And they match my tie and all that. Okay, thank you very much. Now, Don, so many people have been calling in, and again, we've been getting more and more folks telling us about their favorite psalm. Now, you've got something else you wanted to share with us in there.
How great thou art. What a great God we do serve. Psalm 145. Mercy. If you got your Bible near you tonight, open that psalm.
Yes, sir. There it is.
It's fullness. There's 10 areas that David lists. David wrote this psalm. It was called the crown jewel of praise. Mm-hmm. And he was praising God for his greatness and his mm-hmm. might. Mm-hmm. His goodness and his righteousness and his holiness, graciousness,
mercy,
his compassion, his mercifulness, nearness, and preserves and keeps. And that's just a beginning. We could go on and on from that. But.
And you know, tonight, Don, and Patsy called it, she said Psalm 91 is her favorite because it covers healing, protection, and faithfulness, much like you have been saying mm-hmm. all night long. Here's someone, Greg Hansorth, if I made that, he said Psalm 91 for protection, and then Psalm 22 talks about the crucifixion.
It does.
And again, the prophecy. Now, I know we've been talking so much we have to say. People can get this book. Where and how can they?
Okay, they can get it. We're in our second production. We had to reorder.
Isn't that great? Praise his name.
I never dreamed we would do that. But you can order them at, send me a note at Don Harkins, 308 okay. South Severn Circle.
There it is.
The address is up there. $15. We sell them at cost. We're not making any money. Plus
right.
$3 for postage.
Right. And so or they could call you at
864-201. Give me the information. We'll get them right out. Right.
And you'll autograph it if they ask for your autograph.
If they do.
Sure. I mean, listen, I am one of these that since I've been coming, I don't know how many hundreds of books or tapes that I have, and I always ask people to autograph them for me.
Be glad to do that.
I mean, and so, you know, and if you would like for Don to say to Benny from Don Harkins, and he'll put whatever in there, he'll autograph that for you. If you maybe have someone in the family you'd like to give as a gift, why not? I mean, and if you'll let Don, you can write him or call him. We'll put that information up one more time. What a lovely gift. Now, were there other things? I know so many things in there that you wanted to call our attention to that I don't, time will catch
you. As far as ordering the books, we've got a dear brother that lives in West Virginia that has a contribution in here, and he got his book, and he ordered 20 for his, he's got a small church,
right.
And gave to all of his church family.
That's
members.
Great. And you know, somehow you could almost use this in some ways as a semi-daily Bible guide of reading.
Several people told me they were doing that.
And I mean, and what a way to go through it. Not only do you read the psalm, but then you can see some comment about the psalm.
Right.
And
we've got, like I said, 58 people who contribute. There's about 12 or 14 ministers that contributed to our book, and we're thankful for them and their expertise. And but it's anywhere from Evie, some of the younger teens in our church made contributions, and people from West Virginia all the way to Texas and in between, and Oklahoma and Colorado.
You're going to have a lot of production. You're going to do more than just a second.
Well, we just ask God
to
use it and bless people. And that's like I said, we want to be a blessing.
Yeah.
And that's my desire.
And you know, and again, there's no way there, as much as there is great literature out there today, there's still nothing that can touch or top the Psalms.
Exactly. This is just a simple publication
from
the heart.
But it's profound. Mm-hmm. I mean, either way you look at it, the Psalms are profound.
They are indeed.
And inspired by the Spirit of God, written by men who allowed that Spirit to come into their hearts, and they wrote as the Spirit dictated to them. Mm. And, you know, I was telling you earlier, when you go to the Holy Land, you go to David's tomb. It is an experience, not like going to the empty tomb of Christ, but it is an experience, because I remember when I went and we were standing in line to view and visit the tomb, I took this Bible with me, and as I was looking at the tomb, I was reading, "The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want." And Don, I tell you, I'll tell you, that'll speak.
Yeah.
And you know, it just does. And I hope and pray you've been listening tonight, I hope that, come on, you can call, have a few more minutes to call in, because we're going to be handing these over to Don after the program on these who've called in. I'm amazed at the folks who've been saying Psalm 91.
I know it.
Yeah. I mean, you know, it's a great psalm. I'm not taking anything away from it, but I'm just amazed at how many
people. I think
people,
it's the day in which we live. People are looking to Psalm 91 for guidance and protection, and it's a... He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. And one of my favorite verses is verse 2. I will say of the Lord, He is my refuge and fortress, my God, in Him will I trust. Sort of a testimony.
Surely He will deliver you.
And then another great down. He shall call upon me and I will answer him.
That's right.
And be with him in trouble.
What affirmation. Come on now.
Yeah.
I will call on. He'll answer. He said it in His Word.
Yeah, He did.
I mean, come on. I mean, what more can you ask for when you know. And a lot of time we call on him, and if he doesn't answer the way we want him to, we say, well, he didn't answer.
Or when we ask him.
Yeah, you know.
It's his time. Isn't
it? Yeah, it is. And Don, anything else, I know we've got a song coming up in just a moment or two.
We're excited about the second volume.
It's going to be great. Any idea when it might be released?
Well, we had a date set, but we kind of missed the cutoff. Some of the people who are writing on the special subjects haven't completed their assignment or whatever.
Right.
So we're hoping by, and we can have these, we self-publish.
Right.
So we do all the artwork, all the formatting, and there's a printer in 48-hour printer, publisher in Columbus, Ohio.
Great.
That we can order and have books within a week. So we're hoping by the middle of July we'll have it. We'd hope for the...
That's great.
A little earlier than that. But
and you know, if you're not careful, you may end up doing a whole series of things.
Well, I don't know what...
Really? I mean, you know, it just seems like the Lord just touched you and put things on your heart and mind, and you've been obedient.
But it's a joint effort among many people,
sure,
and I appreciate
sure.
every one of them that's contributed.
And I think that not knowing them, I think I could say they understand that it's a joint effort.
Mm-hmm.
They know your heart.
Right.
But I want to encourage you to get this book. Can we put that address once more up there for Don Harkins? Is that there? It is. You can write him at 308 South Severn Circle in Easley, 29642, or write him at dhark1 Charter.
Should be at charter.
At charter.net, or if you'd like an autograph copy, 864-201-5875. And the name of the new book would be?
And I think we've got the artwork for the cover for the new book. They're supposed to have it back. Yeah, there it is.
Rivers of Life.
Strength from the Psalms.
Strength from the Psalms. All right. Now, there it is. That's I'm just excited to see what other series is going to come out. I mean.
But we gave Judy Aiken, she accepted the challenge to do that using Psalm 3, 1 in verse 3.
Uh-huh, right. Be like a tree planted by
The rivers of water that bringeth forth his fruit in his season.
And with all of that being said, and again, we encourage you to call in, please, with your favorite psalm. Give us your name. And first and last name, and you're granting us permission to place that in Don's book if they so desire, okay? And it's not that what you're sharing with us is not important, but sometimes there's redundancy, et cetera, et cetera. But Don will certainly appreciate it. I know in just a moment we've got a song coming up, but I know you encourage people. We're going to come back in just a moment. I want you to encourage folks when we come back from this song, all right? Because Don has so much to share with you right now. Court Heath, you're going to love this. People need the Lord. Court!
Every day they hear pass me by, I can see it in their eyes. Empty people filled with pain, heading who knows where. On they go through private pain, feeling tears. Laughter hides their silent cries. Only Jesus hears. People need the Lord. People people need the Lord. We are called to be a light in this world where wrong seems right. What could be too great a cost for sharing life with one who's lost? Through his love, our hearts can feel all the grief they bear. They will learn to do his will. This life he shares, people need the Lord, people need the Lord. At the end of broken dreams, he's the open door.
Thank you, Court, for that beautiful song tonight, so relevant for the day in which we live. People do need the Lord everywhere. Even those who have known him as Lord and Savior, there's so much fear and anguish in the land today. And just want to let everybody know that there's hope in Jesus Christ. You can go to God's Word, find peace and happiness and all that you need. Go to the Psalms, get involved in the Psalms, memorize them and pray them. God will help you. Psalm 34 and 4, David, after all of his victories as a young boy, he's now old, and he says, I sought the Lord, and he heard me, and delivered me from all the fear. So we know that David got word through to the Lord, and he touched him, and you can do that tonight if you've got fear in your life, and if you don't know the Lord, call upon him and he'll accept you. And we'll all be together one day in heaven. And we just thank the Lord for the opportunity to share tonight and just turn to him. And I again encourage everybody to get into the Psalms. There's so much there. And the more you read them and the more you pray them, the closer you'll become with the Lord. And he'll meet you and help you there. And we just thank Pastor Benny for giving us the opportunity tonight to share. And we love all of you out there. And just turn to God and trust him. I know there's many who watch Nightline that aren't in the right relationship with the Lord. So call upon him tonight, and he'll relieve all that fear and the problems in your life. Thank you.
Don Harkins, thank you. And Court, thank you. And Evie, you know, so many of you write in, but I've got to share this prayer request. And it's simply this. I would like prayer for me to let go of my wife. She passed 2 months ago of Alzheimer's. She was in the nursing home 5 years. My heart is so heavy. I'm not well, and I can't walk good. I don't know who you are, but the Lord does.
He does.
And it just struck me to tell you we're praying for you right now.
Touch him, oh God.
With all of these prayer requests. Don, join with me. Lay hands on them. I'm going to offer this prayer.
Yes.
I want you to bow with me at home, wherever you might be. Loving Father, you know every need,
yes,
every
do,
individual. You've numbered the hair on their head. You know their social security number. You know their zip code. You know everything. Lord, I pray that you will touch and heal and remind them that Lord, you said you'd never leave nor forsake us. We claim that for all of these who called in tonight. So hear our prayer, Lord.
Yes,
hear our
Lord.
Prayer, because the Lord is my shepherd, I shall never have a want.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord Jesus, we offer this prayer in your mighty name. Amen.
Hallelujah.
And amen. Thank you so much for being part of Nightline. We've had a lot of fun tonight, hadn't we? Don Harkins, God bless you. You're
bless
my friend,
you,
and I love you. Can't wait to be with you again soon.
Thank you.
Evie, thank you. And Court, thank you. And Miss Sylvia Tanner, thank you for the piano. Thank all these folks. Deegan's been doing all the flooring here. Thank you, Fred. Thank you, Monica. Everybody back on the other side of the wall. I'm Pastor Benny. I'll see you Sunday. God bless. Bye-bye now.